immediately and jumped in the car and drove back. She called her husband, and so she was terrified. When the told me, she said, listen, not a few days ago, she was the one holding a broom and, you know, celebrating. In doing so, you are inviting these demons. Now you have been inviting them, they come to you, you begin to scream. Demonic practices, brethren, they open the door to demons to come into your life. And in that condition, you can even say, in the name of Jesus, go out of here. You call him, you open the door for him to come. Do you think he's going to go? Listen, we can exercise a full authority to cast evil spirits out if we ourselves are in the will of God. If you are outside the will of God, my friends, demons are going to they are going to resist. They are going to say, we don't want to go. See? But of course, let's just continue. We talked about those who use divination. Now, for a child of God, we really don't want any person to tell us your future will be like this or like that, because we already know how our future is going to be. By faith, we know if we believe. God says in the book of Jeremiah 29, I know the project I have for you. It's a good project, not a project to harm you, but a project to give you a good end. And as long as the child of God obeys, things are going to be well for him. And we're not going to also to preach here that everything is going to be all right and money is and all that. But as David said, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. And at the end he says, at the end of Psalm chapter 23, he says, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. Not part of it, all the days of my life. So why should we go and begin to want to know what is going to happen tomorrow or whatever? Our future is bright by God's grace.
Amen.
And then we looked at an enchanter. An enchanter is a person who has magical powers and claims to want to help the mortals, but at the same time they can do things that can astonish people. Like I said about that, you know, you go to India, somebody can be there using certain power, looking at, you know, they seem to be lost, and then they stand in the middle of a fire. Their clothes are not being burned, and they are not feeling anything. By what power are they doing? Strange enough. People criticize the Bible, they say, well, the Bible is fiction. When they read about Daniel, you know, and Abednego, who were in the fire and they didn't burn. Now, if Satan can do these things, demons can do it. Do you think God does not have the power to do it? Of course he can. And we looked at another one. I think the French word is used is augure, but let me say here, see what is, divination, observer of times, or an enchanter. Yeah. So a little bit an observer of time, actually, is somebody who looks at the natural signs, like a thunder, and then using it to try to predict the future, which direction the birds are flying. You know, or which way the wind is blowing. From there, using this natural sign to want to predict the future. And of course, we know astrologers, they look at the planets, and they say it's Venus and so forth, have a line that means that if you were born in December or 25th and so forth, you know, that means you are going to be, and we spoke about it. It's a dangerous thing. Horoscopes are not for us. You know, like there's a woman, especially, who works for the lottery, I think. Her name is a Mystic Meg. That's what they call it. And whenever the lottery is playing, they would ask you, now, you mystic man, what do you think? Oh, this time I can see, I think the star is shining over Yorkshire. And you see people believing in these things. They go to buy tickets thinking we are in Yorkshire. Sheffield is in Yorkshire, that means it can be my hat. But all these are just a demon. And as a children of God, if we begin to do these things before God, it is looked upon as a prostitution. Just like a woman who is married would go outside, prostitute herself with another man. This is the way God sees it. If a child of God begins to read horoscopes, you know, oh, when was I born? I'm Capricorn, brother. What are you now? We don't even want to talk about those things.
Amen.
Because it is astrology and is demonic. And of course, the Bible also talks about a witch. Now, for witches, you know them, like in Africa, we all know plenty of witches. They can sometimes lead you to a small house, like in South Africa, they call them sangoma. You go to a woman, she's got two or three statues over there, and you know, they use a few things, they can talk to the sky, they can talk here and there. All these ceremonies, this is witchcraft. Witchcraft. And sometimes they can talk, you know, call the name of the ancestors and whatever. It's just witchcraft. And sadly, sometimes you find that the whole family can be connected to these things. But as a child of God, you have to stand your ground. If your family is in these things, that all of you used to go there, but as a child of God, you have believed, you have to stand your ground.
Amen.
That I'm not going to go to those things. If they have to reject you, all your family, accept to be rejected. See, it happened to me. And of course, I still had to depend on the family in terms of food that was not working. The whole family, well, we all have to go to a certain man called Yonzika. But I said, Daddy, I'm not going to go. With all the respect I give to you, I'm a Christian, I can't go. At first you're saying, nobody's going to. I said, I cannot go. I'm telling you, I respect you, but concerning that man, I'm not going to go. And at the end, he let me out and the rest of the family went. Why? Because these things are dangerous. If you open up to them, you are playing with your own soul. You defile your soul, and this can lead to an eternal separation from God. And especially us, brothers, we are called to be the bride. And you cannot make it to be the bride if you don't please God. If you don't please God. See? A witch. And 11, or a charmer. Sometimes charmers use what we call hypnotization. Like people who dance with the snake, they claim to have magic power, they hypnotize the snake. Hypnotherapy. Sometimes even they are called using. These are, people possessed with demonic powers. But yet, they claim hypnotherapy can heal people. Like there's a man here, a TV personality called John McKenna. And many a time, he organizes big, if you have a problem that is troubling you, try hypnotherapy. Hypnotherapy, therapy means actually a cure. Hypnotization trying to cure people. How can anything demonic cure? Even if you go as a brother, I feel better. It's only a demon making you a little bit comfortable. Because no demon can cast out a demon. But demons can agree to each other. Do you know that? Brother Branham gives an example. He says he was in a meeting. And one man was sitting there, and Brother Brennan could just see a black shadow on the man. And the Lord gave him a discernment that this man is doubting what you are talking about. Because he was trying to discern a few things, and you said, that woman over there, you know, your name is so and so. He was doing it by the power of God, but there was a man sitting down. He was just thinking, no, 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 this man must be using something of the devil. And immediately, Brother Branham saw another man in the other, you know, corner of the congregation. He too had a black cloud. That also showed the man was out. Now, remember, even if you watch that video called Deep Course to the Deep, many times Brother Branham was feeling it. And he would just turn to him and say, friend, it's not me, it's the Lord, please. Take it, it's not me. You can watch it again. He was feeling it. But yet the man was connected over there, a sat over there, and another one in front, and all of a sudden Brother could see the connection between the darkness. Between the dark man and the man who was sitting in front. They are in the same place, demons, but yet they could connect to each other. They could connect to each other. See,